there's 63 million South Africans, right? The money you guys are owing is 61 billion USD. Billion. Keyword B, billion. So you're telling me how many people are working in South Africa again that are paying taxes? Brother, come on, let's be real. Let's be real. Please. Just make peace with that. Foreigners are here to stay. So please.
No, nobody's saying foreigners, all foreigners must leave, because we've been living with Nigerians and
Kenyans.
Why do you feel attacked, guys? This is a conversation, it's a debate. Don't feel attacked. Stand up for yourself. Don't say why you're cornering me. Stand up for yourself. Also, you stand on business. Also, you stop feeling intimidated by
You see why I kept quiet. You said earlier that is it wrong when the South Africans ask all foreign nationals to, you said that was your statement. Is it wrong? You didn't say for the ones that are committing crime to leave, for the ones that are undocumented to leave. You said for all foreign nationals to leave. Is it wrong for them to ask that?
I said is it wrong for when South Africans say that foreigners should leave? When they say foreigners should leave, there's a difference. I'm not breaking down what I said. I don't know if there's a recording we could go back to, but I know what I said.
You want answer to that?
Sorry?
You want answer to that, if it's wrong?
Yes, if it's wrong.
In
opinion and say they don't want this, they don't want that, they don't want foreigners. Why is it wrong and how is it wrong? Okay, you explain the how and why is it wrong.
First of all, why are they asking the foreigners to leave?
Because they have different opinions and reasons why.
Why are they asking the foreigners to leave?
The reasons are different. They are plain.
Give me a few of them.
Obviously, others have bad history with foreigners. Others feel like they are being overcrowded. Others feel like they don't belong here.
How many foreigners do you have in South Africa that you are being overcrowded?
Are you asking me statistically? Because others are undocumented, so we can't have like.
You're gonna answer me statistically. You're not gonna just tell me 7 million.
How can I say 7? How would I know 7 million if statistically they are not all recorded? So 7 million is not the correct number.
How many are recorded?
I have no idea how many are recorded.
How many are not recorded?
I still have no idea. And I also
What do you know?
I know that South Africans have an opinion, and one South African, an ordinary South African like me, has an opinion on the other side.
Okay,
of
what's your own, what's your own,
yeah,
what's
please
your
allow own, me to finish what? Please allow me to finish speak before you get this out. I know this might sound unintelligent to you, but at least give me the be civil. Okay. Let me finish. I know I sound unintelligent, so just let me finish and then you answer me. Okay, I listen.
Okay,
that's how it works.
All right, let's go.
What I was saying is,
you said opinion. I can help you with that. You said if South Africans have opinion, this and that,
if ordinary South Africans like me say foreigners are doing this and that, one, two, what? They are committing most crimes. They are not, selling whatever it is. Why is it we are seen as being wrong? Why do I create about to intellectualize the whole concept of it? Why? Why is nobody listening to the ordinary South African?
Okay, so wait, you just said most commit crimes, and this is individual opinion, right?
Yeah.
So how many criminals do you know?
How many criminals do I know?
Yes, I think you're an individual, right? You're an individual.
Yeah, yeah.
How many foreign criminals do you know?
Do you mean personally or just by
profile? Obvious. Personally.
No,
we're not doing statistics right now.
Yeah.
We're doing lived experience, on the ground experience.
Yeah.
How many criminals do you know?
None.
We don't know any.
Any foreign criminals? None.
You don't know.
Yeah.
Okay. Does your neighbor know any foreign criminals?
I don't know if they know any foreign criminals.
Bro, you see what you are doing to yourself.
What am I doing?
Me too, in the yard.
Do you see what you are doing to yourself?
Where are you guys getting with this, honestly?
I don't know what I'm doing. Please tell me.
You're saying, so what is wrong with individual South Africans complaining about this and that? You even use yourself as reference. What do you know? You don't know nothing. I asked you for statistics. You said there's no record. So what are you, what's your grievances?
So when you're asking me is, because I've been mugged before. So when you're asking me is, if I'm working in Jersey and I'm being mugged and it's my experience and I've lived it, I should ask whoever's mugging me their nationality and say what's your name. Like right now, the question you asked me, you must saying I must ask the person who mugged me, what's your name, tell me your nationality, and then after that, then tell them, okay, it's fine, you can leave. So that's
so, someone mugged you, you didn't ask them their nationality, you came, you concluded they are foreign national. Matt, take over. Thank you.
That's what you're saying,
Sage.
So how did you know that person was a foreigner? That's what I want to know, because when you're getting mad, it's kind of hard to tell who's who in this
room. I have somebody I know in this hotel. I don't want to talk about him. I was visiting him in CBD. I think he was moving. I know him. He's my brother's friend. Do you understand? During the day, I was sent to Spaza shop to go, and I'm from Soweto, so I was acting out clever, and then I got mugged. And then when you talked about it, Andrew said, these boys are so and so, they are from Zim, like they are from the rural of Zim. You understand? I hope this does not come across as untold. He's from the rural, they're from Zim, I know them. I even described them, their facial features, and he said, yes, that's from Zim. You call them by name.
Can you believe Sena, do you guys remember me asking him, does he know any criminal, a foreign criminal? He said no, he doesn't know any. Does your friend or anyone you are close to know any foreign criminal? You said no to me, brother. What are you doing?
The person I'm talking about is my brother's friend, so he's not my friend.
But it's still someone that you know.
Wait, Serge, I remembered something and I need to address it. 44, are you still there? 44, I'm not going to be hostile. Are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay, 44, remember when I said South African people are also committing the same crimes as Nigerians that you people claim that they are committing in South Africa? They are committing the same crimes in other countries, ne? And then you said, but they are only transporters. I just want to know, what did you mean by that? Are you saying they are only peddlers and traffickers of that powder?
So what I was trying to say is that in Indonesia, I'm pretty sure there's no more than 100 South Africans there.
Right? I wasn't saying that there are hundreds South Africans.
Yeah. So if there are not hundreds of people there, so it's rare for the locals there to have issues with South Africans, because they rarely interact with those people. Whereas compared to South Africa, we have over 30K of Nigerians in South Africa.
Okay, I hear you. So you're saying that powder comes into South Africa by Nigerians. They bring it to South Africa. What are you saying exactly? Because I'm trying to understand what you're saying. That's why I'm asking.
I'm saying.
Okay.
In South Africa, mm-hmm. The context is different because we have Sunnyside. Well, which is mostly
Nigerians. Why would you guys keep using Sunnyside as a reference?
No, it's not
exactly.
Continue.
So, for example, Sunnyside, Hillbro, those are majority places that foreigners live by. So most of the Africans, when they go to those places, they feel like they're not living in their country.
Mm.
Yeah, so that's why I think that's why they have issues. So unlike in Philippines, you can't find a community that is exclusively South Africans live there. You won't.
Mm. Oh, okay. So you know the numbers of South Africans that are in Indonesia.
I don't. I can look it up now, because I don't want to say numbers that are not correct. So I can type it now, then Google it now, and then tell you the number.
You already did. You said there are not even 100 more. There are less than 100. You said that those are what you were right.
Yes. I said. I'm sure they're not. I didn't say.
Yes, when you say I'm sure, it means you're sitting there. No wonder.
Okay. I made a mistake there. Okay, but that's fine.
Okay, now I need to ask you another question.
Okay.
So, you're saying the brothers in Sunnyside and Hillbro are the ones who are pushing this thing?
No, I didn't say.
I was speaking about the crime that South Africans are constantly complaining about, which is powder. And okay. I even said our South African people are also pushing the same thing in other countries, right? And then when you answered me while I'm still speaking, you said, but they are curious. So I want to know the statement of, but they are curious. If South Africans are curious, you're saying that they are carrying small amounts of powder, but big amounts of powder are carried by Nigerians.
No.
Then what are you saying?
Powder doesn't have any limit. You have people from Brazil. You have people from whatever that are actually doing this thing. I cannot say.
But you keep referring to Nigerians in Lagos and not in Lagos, I mean in Sunnyside and in Hillbro, when I'm speaking about that powder being trafficked and peddled by South Africans in other countries. You mentioned Sunnyside and you mentioned Hillbro. They are doing those things in Sunnyside.
I was saying, in South Africa, there are certain communities that majority of people that live there are Nigerians or are foreigners. That's what I said. I didn't say anything about people pushing powder or anything.
The context is about powder. You're answering to that context about powder, and you're still mentioning that Nigerians are in Sunnyside and in Hillbro. I told you, we listen attentively and we attack what you're saying. We are attacking what you're saying. So now, I am going to tell you something that you and other South African people don't know, right? Powder is not trafficked into the country. Actually, powder is not coming into the country by traffickers and peddlers. Those are the ones, the little ones who are used to actually transport that powder right to other countries once it has landed in South Africa. It is not trafficked and peddled by Nigerians or South Africans or any African person in South Africa. It comes by the owners, the kingpins, and they use ports, they use harbors, they even use borders. All right, that's how the powder comes in. Now, the peddlers are not only Nigerian. Yes, we are aware that Nigerians are also, not all of them, actually, a small amount of them are traffickers and peddlers, just like a small amount of South Africans are peddlers and traffickers. They take this powder out of South Africa to other countries. That's why we have stories like there's been a 200 million or was it billion bust in a farm, at a white farm by that in South Africa, while they were still busy manufacturing that thing, producing that thing, putting that thing together, they busted them. And also a South African national was also caught with that Mexican. It wasn't a Nigerian, it was a Mexican. When they catch a kingpin, a South African is connected to that kingpin. That's why on the Hawks website, when they talk about powder, they mention that that powder came into the country through the help of South Africans. It came with a kingpin that's not even African. I wish my South African people could just grasp what I'm saying. It's there on the internet. You can read it. It's on Times. They spoke about it. News 24, it's there. Maverick, it's there. ENCA, it's there. SABC News, it's there. It's on the internet. You can read it. Hey guys, if you're going to talk about powder, okay, and you want Nigerian people to be accountable and hold their people accountable, can you also give them the same courtesy and hold your South African people accountable? Already there are people on the waiting list. You know, it said a waiting list to be analyzed in another country, because when you thought you'd be on vacation peddling this powder to another country, and you want to disguise it because you're now South African and you think you can come into the country that easily. If you don't know, Africans are flagged everywhere. You cannot, even a South African, you cannot go to another country and enter freely. You'll be profiled whether you like it or not. You'll be profiled. They do this all the time. I even watch documentaries about airports. When it comes to Africans, they are not even afraid to say, we profile them. We are already assuming that they are bringing the powder into the country, especially if they have luggage that has things, something like clothes to sell their site. Automatically, they think that same clothes is hiding powder. But you, South Africans, don't want to accept that. You want to chastise the Nigerians, and it's not right. It's not okay. Now, this brother is also saying that he was he was mugged by a Zimbabwean. There's a narrative by white, even those pale people, they have a narrative that Zimbabweans are the ones who are committing farm crimes. The Zimbabweans are the ones who are crossing the border to come and analyze white farmers so that they can take their crops, their cattle and everything else and their money. And it's not true. If we are to go to those white farms, I'm telling you, we are going to find our ancestors in shallow graves there. So please, can you stop this narrative of crime has a nationality? It doesn't.
You and Tumi, before you reply, the big screen, are you guys aware of that story?
Well, we know. We not say South Africans have done commit crime or don't petty powder. We know that. We all are aware.
That's why you're all aware. Okay. I'll let you come in there. Tumi said most crime that happens in South Africa are committed by foreign nationals. Tumi, do you know about the Hawks statistic that came out, I think last month or last 2 months, that 77% of crime committed in South Africa are done by the citizens?
No, I'm not aware of that stat. Thank you for it.
Okay, I'm aware. So,
My brother, Tumi.
Yeah, bro.
Okay, what is going on in your country? What do you know that is going on in your country? just be honest with me.
I know that people are confused in terms of what direction to take.
I don't want what people are too confused on TikTok. You as like you follow government, whatever news or what is happening. What,
my man, I can only talk about the general consensus here.
No, I'm saying, like, I asked you about statistics, you don't know. I asked you about this, you don't know. When last did the petrol price drop in South Africa?
My man, I can talk about the general consensus. Just because I don't know your stats doesn't mean correct. I'm not aware of what's happening in South Africa.
The petrol price, when did it drop?
Last month it dropped twice or three times.
To how much?
To how much? I forgot. All three of them.
Guys, carry on.
Can I respond to the statistics?
Yes, 44.
Okay. So, I'm not sure why people, I don't understand why people are surprised by the statistics. Obviously, the statistics are South African statistics. They're going to be more because South Africans live here. If you go to China, majority of the crime that is committed there is committed by Chinese. If you go to India, same thing, same story. So, I'm not sure why people are surprised by that.
No, I'm just because Tumi said most crime. Yeah, we know about the statistics, but Tumi said most crime that has happened in South Africa are committed by foreigners.
Most.
Can I also like respond on the one as well? Let's be honest as well. Let's not be biased, right? So as a South African, if I go to Zimbabwe and commit crime, because I'm not documented there, how are they going to count me in their statistics? Because I'm not documented. They don't know me.
Were you arrested for committing that crime?
I'm saying.
No. Were you arrested? You went to Zimbabwe, you committed a crime.
No.
Were you ever caught?
No.
You were not caught.
Hypothetical. Let's give you an example, right?
I understand the example you are making.
Yeah.
So you are not caught.
You're not caught. So
you got away with crime.
Okay. Yeah. So obviously, the statistics will count me because I was never caught.
Hold on, 44. Do you know that if a foreign national commits a crime in South Africa or in anywhere in a country, whether they are documented or not by the system, they will still be recorded as criminals? Do you know that when the case is open, do you know that that case number is recorded?
Yeah, they record the case number.
How come then that doesn't count as statistics?
I'm telling you
they caught this person is not legalized, doesn't have proper document, but they still opened the case, they arrested him, they put him inside. Don't you think that case number is being recorded as statistics?
On what? How are you gonna link it to anybody? What do you mean?
You go to Zimbabwe, you are 44, you don't have papers, you commit a crime, they arrest you as 44. When they open a case against you, they're gonna ask you what's your name. You say you will say 44. Where are you from? South Africa. Do you have papers to be here? No. Already you are recorded as a criminal.
So if you recall, what other recording do you want? If you're not caught, if now I go to Mozambique and steal something and come back to South Africa, you don't know how to
We'll come back to you. Let's give Ogwari a chance to speak. We'll come back. You see, us, we are here today. Ogwari, come in, my brother.
I'm here. Can you guys hear me?
Yes.
Okay, I really want to talk more on this immigration level and aspect of it. You know, sometimes they say people are illegal, undocumented. How is that possible? Because first of all, if I go to a country whereby